Elisha prays for rain and anoints Elisha as prophet. Mount Carmel. After the contest between Elisha and the prophets of Baal on Mount Carmel, Elisha said to King Ahab, "Now go and eat. I hear the roar of rain approaching." While Ahab went to eat, Elisha climbed to the top of Mount Carmel, where he bowed down to the ground with his head between his knees and prayed to God for rain. He said to his servant, "Go and look towards the sea." The servant went and returned saying, "I did not see anything." Then Elisha prayed for the second time and sent his servant to go and look at the sea. His servant went up to see that he can find any sign of rain. He saw throughout the sea, but he did not find any sign of rain. So he returned to Elisha to say that there was still no sign of rain. Then Elisha again prayed to God for the third time. In this way, seven times in all, he prayed to God and told his servant to go and look at the sea. The seventh time, servant returned and said, "I saw a little cloud no bigger than a man's hand coming up from the sea." Elisha ordered his servant, "Go to King Ahab and tell him to get into his chariot and go back home before the rain stops him." In a little while, the sky was covered with dark clouds, the wind began to blow, and heavy rain began to fall. King Ahab got into his chariot and started back to Jezreel. The power of the Lord came on Elisha. He fastened his clothes tight round his waist and ran ahead of Ahab all the way to Jezreel. After reaching home, King Ahab told his wife Jezebel everything that Elisha had done and how he had put all the prophets of Baal to death. Then Jezebel sent a message to Elisha, "May the gods strike me dead if by this time tomorrow I do not do the same thing to you that you did to the prophets." So Elisha was afraid and fled for his life. He took his servant and went to Beersheba in Judah. Elisha left his servant in Judah and he walked a whole day into the wilderness. He stopped and sat down in the shade of a tree and wished he would die. "It's too much, Lord," he prayed. "Take away my life. I might as well be dead." He lay down under the tree and fell asleep. Suddenly, an angel touched him and said, "Wake up and eat." Elisha got up and looked around and saw a loaf of bread and a jar of water near his head. He ate and drank and lay down again. The Lord's angel returned and woke him up a second time, saying, "Get up and eat, or the journey will be too much for you." Elisha got up, ate and drank. The Holy Mountain. Food gave Elisha enough strength to walk 40 days to Sinai, the holy mountain. There, he went into a cave to spend the night. Suddenly, the Lord spoke to him, "Elijah, what are you doing here?" Elijah answered, "Lord God Almighty, I have always served you, you alone, but the people of Israel have broken their covenant with you, torn down your altars, and killed all your prophets. I am the only one left, and they are trying to kill me." The Lord said to Elijah, "Go out and stand before me on top of the mountain." Then the Lord passed by and sent a furious wind that split the hills and shattered the rocks. But the Lord was not in the wind. The wind stopped blowing, and then there was an earthquake. But the Lord was not in the earthquake. After the earthquake, there was a fire, but the Lord was not in the fire. And after the fire, there was a soft whisper of a voice. When Elijah heard it, he covered his face with his cloak and went out and stood at the entrance of the cave. A voice said to him, "Elijah, what are you doing here?" Then Elijah answered that, "Jezebel was trying to kill me." Then the Lord said to Elijah, "Return to the wilderness near Damascus. Then enter the city and anoint Hazael as king of Syria. Anoint Jehu son of Nimshi as king of Israel. And anoint Elisha, son of Shaphat, from Abel-Meholah to succeed you as prophet. Anyone who escapes being put to death by Hazael will be killed by Jehu, and anyone who escapes Jehu will be killed by Elisha. Yet I will leave 7,000 people alive in Israel, all those who are loyal to me and have not bowed to Baal." The call of Elisha. Elijah left and found Elisha plowing with a team of oxen. There were 11 teams ahead of him, and he was plowing with the last one. Elijah took off his cloak and put it on Elisha. Elisha then left his oxen, ran after Elijah, and said, "Let me tell my father and mother goodbye, and then I will go with you." Elijah answered, "All right, go back. I am not stopping you." Then Elisha went to his team of oxen, killed them and cooked the meat using the yoke as fuel for the fire. He gave the meat to the people and they ate it. Then Elisha said goodbye to everyone and went and followed Elijah as his helper.